You may remember the scene where a guy wearing number 0 heaved up a half-court shot and left the floor in tears as his team was eliminated from the NCAA tournament. That guy had a career-high 38-point game. That guy on that day became the all-time leading scorer in Kansas State's program history. That guy was also a senior. All he wanted was a chance to play in the Final Four. It never came. Now the big decisions are upon you. They can either stunt your growth or make you a growth spurt feature. Closed minds think that making the NBA is everything. Ask any overseas player if that matters in the end. I guess that's a question I can answer. Not at all. But it doesn't stop us from talking about the reasons Jacob Pullen is not in the NBA, even after all his success. Salute to my man Blake the Great for this request. Day one right there. Gang, gang. Today's feature, Jacob Iversay Pullen. Born November 10th, 1989. It's your boy JC Stunted Growth. Ash, get it, man. Stunt number one, stayed a bit too long. There's this thing the NBA does where they place so much bet on youth more than ever. It used to be you were a four-year player, so you were looked at as having maturity and poise on the floor. But ever since the age rule has been implemented, one-and-dones have been highly coveted. They're no longer looking for a guy that spent 4 years in college in most situations. They somehow relate it to your potential of being great for their franchise. As if 3 years really matters, right? It does, to them anyway. Pullen made the mistake of staying a bit too long in college. Coming from Maywood, Illinois, he would find it a bit difficult to garner attention due to the focus on players like Iman Shumpert and Patrick Beverley, who were next up in the city's great point guards. He managed to receive some attention at a Nike camp, and teams like Marquette, Oklahoma, and K-State were now interested. He chose to attend State because it gave him a chance to play right away, and also with Michael Beasley, a guy he's had tons of amateur battles with prior to and shares a mutual respect. Pullen would do a lot for K-State. By his sophomore year, he was the man on the team and averaging 13 points a game in 30 minutes. The very next season, he upped his averages tremendously and had, in my opinion, the best year out of the four. The reason is because doing anything that's not expected from a younger guy is a lot more impressive in the eyes of others for some reason, and his numbers suggested so. He played 31 minutes and averaged 19 points and 3 assists, and shot a career best 39% from 3. This is when he should have left State. He was a junior, meaning teams would have viewed him as a player with potential, and that word is all that matters sometimes. Pullen came back to school, and although showed improvement, it wasn't enough, especially now a senior and not viewed as quote young by today's standard of prospects. He averaged 20 points a game, virtually the same assist numbers, and shot almost the exact percentages. For a senior at a school like K-State, at his size, you have to average at least 25 to 30 a game to make some noise, a la Trae Young, close to 30, and gave you almost 10 assists. Pullen's numbers were good, but not good enough, especially because of this. Stunt number two, Pullen's bag wasn't that deep. If you watched him play, even to this day, you'd probably leave thinking, man, that guy was solid. That's exactly what he is, and what the NBA isn't always looking for. Don't get me wrong, being solid is a great thing. Ask Fred VanVleet, but your chances of getting by or finding a team that's looking for solid are much more slim. Jacob didn't do much other than score the basketball, and even then, he still didn't put up amazing scoring numbers. Trae Young, again, played at sort of the same level school, although I'd give Oklahoma a slight edge, and gave you amazing scoring and passing, and was a great leader. Jacob was an unassuming player that didn't really stand out. To me, he was nice, but in my opinion, he wasn't amazing at his focus and pretty much didn't do too much else, like passing, playing great defense, or even rebounding at the guard position. Stunt number three, windows close. In life in general, opportunity never sticks around waiting for you. You have to be ready and willing, and you have to possess the ability to perform when given that opportunity. Pullen, I think, was actually ready. He did have some ability, but mostly, I don't think he showed he was willing enough. After going undrafted in the 2011 NBA draft, the K-State all-time leading scorer decided it was best for him to go overseas to Italy instead of a D-League placement that would have kept him close and in the eyes of scouts. These decisions usually end in a player actually liking being in that environment where they're worshipped, and also the money is 100 times better. No exaggeration either. PULLEN didn't want to make a lower salary than a McDonald's cashier in the D-League and decided to make a career overseas. And that's exactly what he did. Since being undrafted, PULLEN has played in countless countries and cities, also having stints in the NBA and D-League. He played 3 games with the Sixers in 2017 before being waived by the team and returning to a life overseas. All in all, I think Jacob is a solid player and seems like a good dude that probably will be a coach one day. A charismatic guy that people like and had a great basketball career and life. On July 12, 2019, he signed with the ABA League. Salute to him, and I wish him all the success. It's your boy JC Stunted Growth, and I'm out.